My name is Patrick and I'm from SpyFu.com. Today I'm going to talk about how we recently did an SEO audit for our site. Things we learned, mistakes we made, and hopefully give you some pointers if you ever want to do it for your site. And I think you should, because it's working. This is going to be a different type of video because we used a bunch of tools and software, including but not limited to SpyFu. Better tutorials already exist for these third-party sites, so I'm just going to touch on what they are and how we use them. Why did we decide to do this massive SEO overhaul? It's simple. Our organic ranks started tanking. We started losing a lot of traffic and revenue. Not gonna lie, we kind of freaked out. We wanted to find the culprit, and after some digging, we found out it was a bug on our end dealing with robots.txt. Robots.txt informs Google as well as other web crawlers to index your site so other people can find them. It also allows you to tell Google which sections of your site you don't want indexed. We accidentally set a bug in motion that basically told Google not to index any of our main site. This bug, which is the programming equivalent of turning off the wrong light switch, told Google to de-index hundreds of thousands of pieces of content pretty much overnight. We went from 500,000 pages indexed to 100,000. We got some of that traffic back, but not all of it. It was a crushing blow and an important lesson. Stay vigilant. Our SEO has been fairly consistent over the last decade without us really applying best practices to all of our content. But when you take that approach for a long time, things start to fall through the cracks, including a small bug that tanked our rankings. We thought what we were doing was good enough, and that was our first mistake, one we don't want to make again. We started by implementing a tool called roboto.org. It'll monitor your robots.txt for changes and alert you. It's free, and it's rad. But we didn't want to stop at fixing just the robots.txt. We instead decided it was time to strike from all angles, do everything we could to get our SEO back in good shape. The first thing we tackled, because it was glaring low-hanging fruit, was alt text. We started adding alt text to every image, both on our main site and our resources.spyfu site. Alt text is a short, literal description of an image. So for example, if you had an image on your site with something like this, it could be black, Star Wars coffee mug, Imperial logo. That's your alt text. Alt text helps people find content on your site for images, even if there's no visible description. We use WordPress for our resources site, which is where we keep our blog and tutorial content. In your WordPress account, you can easily go into Media, Library, click on an image, and add the alt text right there. After the alt text was completed, we decided to analyze every piece of content on resources.spyfu. We started with a sitemap, which we got from a WordPress plugin called Yoast. With Yoast, it's very easy to save an XML file of your entire sitemap. We fed this XML file into Screaming Frog. Screaming Frog returns a ton of data, including article titles, H1s, the specific URL of the content, and even if there's any existing canonicalization. We exported the Screaming Frog CSV and imported that into URL Profiler. This tool gave us new information, including free backlink stats for each page and a publish date. It feels strange that the other tools didn't provide that, but the publish date is huge when working with aging content. After we had this snowball of data, we put the entire thing into a Google Doc. In general, we're big fans of Google Docs and Google Sheets. It's free, and it allows multiple people to work on the same document or spreadsheet at the same time. And collaboration was key for a project this size. For each piece of content, there was a row. For each data point for that content, a column. To be honest, we didn't use most of the data. We used a handful of important columns and added some more as the project went on. But we didn't delete any of the data either. Since we were doing the full audit anyway, we wanted to be thorough. With our spreadsheet all set up, it was time to make sure our content was optimized for SEO. Okay, optimized might not be the right word. Perfection is a trap. Our goal in this wasn't to be perfect, but we wanted to be better than yesterday, which is a work ethic of ours. If your goal is to be perfect, you might shoot your productivity in the foot because you're focusing on something that might be unattainable. But if you're simply better than yesterday, you can improve your site as a whole in less time. This approach was pivotal to this project. We had to sift through almost 700 pages with 50 data points each. Being perfect wasn't going to happen. After this massive document was created, we knew we were going to have a problem. In Google Sheets, anything that you change in the document will be changed for everyone. If you add something, delete something, or even sort, that's how the document will be for everyone working on it. We found a solution called filter views, which allow you to set up views for individual users, like sorting and filtering. If you add or delete data, it'll work like normal, meaning it'll change for everyone. But individual filtering and sorting using filter views was an absolute game changer for us. I needed to focus on content that had more than zero videos on it. Cedra needed to filter those out so she could focus on all the articles that she's written. After we realized this, we added even more columns to help us organize this list. I think this is a good time to jump to... Doing prep work is miserable, but was easily the most important part of this entire process. And so a big chunk of this video is going to be about prep work. If you want to skip past this part, simply fast forward to this time. Because honestly, that's what we wanted to do. We wanted to jump in article by article and just fix it. Do the work and fix it. One at a time. This approach might make sense for a smaller project, but we were looking at hundreds of posts that needed analyzing and improving. Doing it post by post would have been more enjoyable, but also would have taken three times as long. The best way to make it manageable, as well as bring other people in to help with the project, was to prep it iteratively. For us, that meant adding a column that identified, in simple terms, what product the post was about. Was it about SpyFu Combat, SpyFu Recon, or even general internet marketing insights? We specialize in a variety of things, and so when we write content, we usually base it around one product, so people can find it easier. Having this extremely simple column helped us organize content into content groups. When you sort by both product and date, you can easily identify what pieces of content are old and need to be 301 redirected or canonicalized to a newer, more relevant piece of content. Since multiple people were adding these labels, they weren't written exactly the same every time, which screwed up the sort, which was the entire point of the column. Not a big deal, we just had to go back a couple of times and standardize them as much as we could. We also added a few very simple columns, including the initials of the person who would fix the content, a description, which eventually devolved into just comments we wanted to make about the content, and a column to X off once the job was done. Finally, we identified what to do in a column, which mostly boiled down to if we should 301, canonicalize, or do an SEO review of the content. These labels were extremely important to the fate of our content and the eventual SEO map of our site. 301 is the harshest. It means if someone clicks on an article or a URL, they will be redirected to a different page. This redirect means that it's impossible for anyone to see the original piece of content ever again. You're basically telling people and Google, this piece of content is worthless and outdated. I want you to see this instead. Canonical is a much softer approach. People can still get to the original article if they click it, but you're letting Google know that there's something better. Canonicalizing tells Google, this piece of content is still somewhat relevant, but we have something better. And then Google will send the link juice to the better piece of content. We canonicalized most of our stuff, and so far, it seems to have been the right move. SEO review was the label we used to identify which articles were still relevant and good. We just needed to make sure that it was SEO friendly, and if it wasn't up to snuff, which most of our content wasn't, we needed to go in there and fix it. We've been asked, how did you determine what needed to be done with each article? And I really wish I had a formula for you. But honestly, that part was mostly gut. Cedra and I have been the primary content creators for almost a decade. So if my gut said that a product video was currently irrelevant, I would label it to be canonicalized or 301'd. If you have an SEO team or a third party that you want to do all of this, I'd recommend that you identify your last site redesign and then have them canonicalize everything before that date. If the link is broken, then 301 redirect it. Be patient. Stay the course. Before I go more into the tools that we used, I want to say that this didn't happen in a day. We went through each piece of content several times in the course of weeks to identify and label each of these simple rows one by one. Again, during this time, we didn't do the actual work of reviewing or redirecting, even though we wanted to. When sticking to this assembly line approach, we were able to fill out the necessary information so we'd be extremely efficient when it came time to do the actual work, as well as delegate some of the more basic tasks to the people who weren't as intimately familiar with the content itself. This turned out to be the right approach. When it came time to do the actual work, we were able to bring Zach on to do things like 301s, canonicalization, and cross-linking on his own time. I mentioned before that we use WordPress for resources.spyfu.com. It's not perfect, but it's simple and it works for us. Using the Yoast plugin for WordPress felt like an SEO cheat sheet. It's somewhat gamified SEO for each article, asking what keywords we wanted to focus on and then giving us pointers on how that article can rank better for those keywords. It's free for most features and crazy affordable for the premier version. We probably couldn't have done this as efficiently without Yoast, and I can't recommend it enough. If you're not on WordPress but know of similar plugins for other blogging platforms, please put it in the comments below. After we started working with the articles themselves, we realized that we needed to add a couple more columns to the sheet. Crosslink, which let us know which content to interlink to within our own site. Google loves these cross connections, especially when they're relevant. So we would add a link to the existing text already in the content, or add a sentence or two to get that link in there. You want to make sure the words that you're adding a link to are relevant to the article that you're linking to. Don't just flood your content with random links attached to random words. Google doesn't like that. At this point, external links weren't our priority. Only URLs within SpyFu. For every piece of content, we double-checked to make sure it also linked back to the product page of our main site. We also added a column for focus keywords. This was simply the keyword that we told Yoast, and in turn Google, what keyword we wanted to focus on. Fortunately, finding and tracking the best keywords in an industry is our specialty. So let's finally talk about SpyFu. We used the same techniques that we recommend to you. First, we went into SpyFu Combat and added our three biggest competitors. We then looked at their core starting keywords, which are the keywords that all three of them share. From there, we could cherry pick the best and most relevant keywords and add them to a MySpyFu project. MySpyFu automatically starts tracking these keywords and their rank changes for our domain. You can do this with your domain as well. It's pretty awesome. If you're unsure what MySpyFu is, I'll include a link to those tutorial videos in the description below. Cross-linking for the win! The joy is that you can go to almost any keyword research page on SpyFu and add these keywords to your project with the click of a button. SpyFu will even let you know if you've already added them, so there won't be any duplicates. This MySpyFu project now includes these keywords. We then separated these keywords into different groups so we could better track their progress when the SEO audit was done. The hope was, after all of this work, we'd see improvements on these groups of keywords. We knew that it should, but we weren't sure that it would. SEO is scary like that. So we started watching the weekly tracking feature like a hawk, praying that eventually our ranks would increase. I hate to spoil the ending, but eventually they did increase. I probably wouldn't be making this video if nothing happened, but so far, it looks like this crazy SEO audit has been worth it. Setting up this project before we actually did the SEO work was a smart move too. It gave us a benchmark on what our ranks were before we started. From this point, we could really see how much this SEO overhaul moved the needle. After we had the keywords ready to go, we exported them and put them in a different Google Sheet for shareability and ease of use. Finally, we got around to the actual work. Here's how it went down. We set up a variety of filter views in the Google Doc. For me, I filtered out everything that didn't have a video or was listed as 301 or canonical, meaning I only got pages with video ready for an SEO review. I then sorted this list by product. This was helpful because it made cross-linking easy. Here are the three relevant pieces of content about backlinks. Have them cross-link to each other. I put my initials by all of those videos, so if I ever needed a different view, I could simply filter by initial. This is why all that prep work was so important. Thanks to all that labeling, I finally had a list of content tailor-made to my eyes. Let's do this step by step. I would open up the URL from the Google Doc. I'd browse the content, maybe watch the video, and then search the keyword document for a keyword I think would fit. I was already logged into my WordPress account, so I just click edit at the top. Add in the crosslinks, unless Zach had already done it, add the focus keyword into Yoast, and then mostly follow Yoast's instructions, including adding the focus keyword to the first paragraph of the content, sometimes changing the SEO title if it looks sloppy, almost always changing the snippet, occasionally just copying and pasting the first sentence or two from the article itself because it already contained the focused SEO keyword, and then clicking update until it said that the SEO was green, or at least yellow.
Take the easy road.
If the content was too complicated, for example, if there was 20 pieces of content for one subject, or the video was kind of old but maybe not too old, I'd skip it. Sometimes I would leave a note about why I skipped it. We weren't sure if this was the best way of doing things at first, but now we highly recommend this approach. It's too easy to get lost in indecision. Thinking too long or too hard about one article will just halt your progress. If you allow yourself to skip anything that's too complicated, you can maintain your momentum of work. Of course, that meant I had to come back to it eventually, but by that time I was more familiar with the content and sometimes knew exactly what I had to do on the second pass. Other times, I was still stumped, and so I'd skip it again. Unfortunately, by the end, all I had left was the really complicated stuff. The stuff I skipped over several times. It did take longer to fix up those articles, but it was easier because I knew I was on the home stretch. I've mentioned this a couple times before, but we also brought in our coworker Zach into this project. While Cedra and I were reconstructing the SEO review content, we had a boatload of 301s and canonicals to take care of. These didn't need extensive editing, like focus keywords and new paragraphs. So Zach used his filter view and knocked them out one by one. How is this done? You can canonicalize things right in Yoast under the advanced settings. Simply paste the URL of the article you think is more relevant. In WordPress, 301 redirects are found under Tools and then Redirection. Scroll to the bottom, enter in the URL you don't want anyone to see anymore, and then the URL of where you want them to go instead. With this approach, we were able to work on this thing both collaboratively and autonomously. Occasionally, we had to discuss what to do with one tricky piece of content or another, but for the most part, we just churned away at it. Do the work, refresh the filter view, repeat until everything has that X marking it as complete. And that was it. Now it's about tracking those keywords and upkeep, because honestly, this sucked. And I never want to do it again. Making sure every new piece of content is SEO friendly before we post it is going to be a standard SpyFu practice from now on. One big regret that I have is a lot of the URLs for these pages weren't SEO friendly. You don't really want to change the URL of existing content, but moving forward, I'm going to pay much more attention to it. Either structuring the URL to better explain the content or including the focus keyword. Probably both. But here's the deal. What we did is working. Our overall SEO numbers are improving. The ranks on our focus keyword groups are increasing across the board. We weren't sure that would be the result, and it's honestly thrilling and heartwarming. And the joy of SEO is knowing that work will have a positive impact forever. Months of hard work for years of payoff. On a more personal note, we learned a lot, both on the struggles you guys have to face on a day-to-day basis and how we can improve SpyFu to make it better for you. I know some of you out there are screaming at your monitor that there's a better way of going about this. If you are that person, please leave a comment below to make this process easier and more bearable for other people. Thank you for sticking around for this long video. I hope you can learn something from our experience and apply the lessons we learned to improve the SEO of your site. As always, thank you for watching.